As the Ukraine war thunders into its 57th day, Russian forces are waging their largest offensive since the invasion began. Ukrainian defenders are besieged in Mariupol. They're making their last stand now in the Azovstal steelworks. 1,000 civilians are reportedly sheltering with them.
We are probably facing our last days, if not hours. The enemy is outnumbering us 10 to 1.
Now, throughout the conflict, we've been checking in with an Australian photojournalist, Bryce Wilson, who has been embedded in Ukraine for the past 7 years. Tonight, though, we're honoured to be able to say we can welcome him at the desk. Bryce, thank you so much for joining us. Just before we get to your experience, this moment, you know, this offensive now in eastern Ukraine, how critical a moment do you think this is in the war?
I think the outcome of the events in Donbass will be used as a measure for the overall success of this phase. So the Donbass for Russia represents like a justification for the invasion. There are propaganda reasons for them to take that, the issuing of passports in that region too, and protecting the interests of the people they say they have there. So I think, as I was saying, the outcome there will really be used to measure who has won this phase of the war.
We heard that the troops in Mariupol, the Ukraine troops, are taking a last stand against the Russian troops. Mm. What are you hearing from your contacts on the ground there?
I have friends who are in that region, people I've known for many years, and I'm seeing them post on Instagram and social media, like, last cries for help, that they need ammunition, they need food. There are civilians in Mariupol that are dying and need critical humanitarian help every day. Even now, as I'm saying this, the messages and like the reports I'm getting from there are that Mariupol, it's an incredibly dire situation and the military there is hanging on barely by a thread.
You've been in Ukraine for the last 7 years, as we heard. You've seen everything unfold in recent months. What was it like coming back to the safety and calm of Australia after being there?
Very surreal. In the days before I left Ukraine to come back here, I was helping deliver food and aid to places where the Russian military had left, and I was seeing people lining up for basic supplies like bread and eggs. And on getting back, I was seeing people lining up for croissants in the CBD, and the disconnect was very surreal, but I think it showed me just how serious the events in Ukraine are.
And you are heading back. You know that 10 journalists have been killed there this year. Why are you putting yourself in that danger?
I would love to continue my reporting in Ukraine in the future, because the events I've seen there and the things that are happening, I think people need to know about this. And even when I have opportunities like this to talk about what is happening in Mariupol, there's like real public value in independent journalism like mine.
Bryce, you're so incredibly brave. You've clearly got a great rapport with the people on the ground there. How are they coping?
I think the sentiment has shifted throughout the conflict, because now the vibe I get is that the Ukrainian people believe they will win this war, no matter the time or the cost. Like, the sentiment there really is keep sending us supplies, like the Bushmasters, for example, that Australia sent, which people in Ukraine have personally told me thank you for. They are saying keep sending us supplies and aid, food, and we will keep fighting, we won't give up.
Do you think you can see Ukraine winning this war?
I'm very surprised by the outcome already. I think many people believe Ukraine would fall, but after 8 years already of fighting war in Donbass, they have one of the most experienced and competent militaries in the world, and I think they will continue fighting.
Well, Bryce, we really appreciate you joining us at the desk, and please have a very safe journey back.
Thank you.